Hey everyone, April Dunham here. So I was doing some planning, trying to decide what video to do this week, and I realized something. Out of all of the videos that I haven't did one related to Power BI. So I thought, what better way to do a Power BI related video than showcase some brand new functionality that lets us run Power Automate flows directly from your Power BI reports. So I'll walk you through how to set it up and how to use it right after this. To get started, you're going to open up the Power BI dashboard or report that you want to execute the flow from. So I have right now open my training dashboard where I can see a list of all the trainings that I have coming up. So the use case here would be I want to be able to filter this by a date and send out an email to everyone letting them know what trainings are coming up the next day. To embed the flow in here, what we need to do is add in the Power Automate visual for this. So we'll go into our visualizations panel. Click on the three dots and select Get More Visuals. Do a search for Power Automate and add in this new Power Automate preview visual. So we get a message that it imported successfully, so we'll click OK. And I will just click on that new Power Automate visual to add that into our canvas here. And you'll see the visual kind of tells you what you need to do. The first thing we want to do here is map the data that we want to take from Power BI and pass into our flow. So in my case, all that I want to do here is pass in the title of the training, the description, and the date. So with this Power Automate visual selected, I'll just select those fields from the right. And now I need to click the three dots next to this visual and click this edit option. This will actually take me to where I can configure the flow now. So there are a few ways to get started. We can use one of these templates here, or we can just say new and instant cloud flow. So what will happen behind the scenes is with this new Power Automate visual for Power BI, it actually added a new trigger for Power BI so that we can do one of these instant cloud flows. If you watched my other videos, you know that I've shown you how we can call flows from Power Apps. So this is the same type of thing. We're going to have a trigger, which is from Power BI in this case, so that we can properly trigger the flow and then perform our workflow logic. Now for this, actually, I do want to use one of these templates. I'm going to use this send a Teams message from Power BI because I want to send out an alert to a particular channel, letting everyone know in that channel what trainings are coming up. So I'm going to select this template here. This flow connects to Power BI and Teams, so it's just going to authenticate into those two connectors, and we'll click continue to go to the edit screen. So here's this brand new trigger I was talking about on Power BI button clicked. And now we have an action below that to post a message to Teams. Now, actually, this one just makes it to where we have to send it to one recipient. So I'm actually going to delete this action and we'll add another one in here. So we'll click a new step. Let's do a search for the Teams connector. And I want this one instead. I want to post a message to a channel instead of an individual user. So we'll select this, post a message as the flow bot to a channel. So in the team dropdown here, I actually have a team called training. That's where I want to post this. And I want to post it in our general channel. For the headline, I'm just going to type in upcoming trainings for tomorrow. And then in the message, this is where I'll pull in some data from that Power BI report. And you see in the dynamic content here, this is where it's pulling in those properties from the report that I mapped. So we have title, description, and training date. Now, what's going to happen here if I select to pull in the title and click that, is you see it's automatically going to wrap this inside and apply to each. That's because this flow knows that the Power BI we're referencing was in a table, so it's tabular data. Therefore, it needs to loop through that tabular data and send the message. So I'll just fill out this message a bit. We'll have the title, I'll pull in that description, and then the date time. This right here is going to send a message for each one that it finds. I could take this a step further and put these results into a table within Power Automate and just send one message that has all of the entries in there. If I wanted to do that, I can come up above this or apply to each, click the plus and add an action. We'll do a search for table and we want to select this data operations connector and we can actually create an HTML table. We can use that action and you see here on the from in the dynamic content, we can actually point that directly to this Power BI data option and under the columns property, just leave it on automatic so that it will take the column headers automatically from our table. And now if we want to do it this way, I'm actually going to delete what we have here and I'm going to move this outside of the apply to each because we don't need it in the apply to each if we're passing it in one tabular data item. So we'll delete that apply to each and in the message, we'll just choose this HTML table output. So now let's click save. And then click save and apply. You have to apply it for this to take effect and have this be bound to the visual that we just added in our report. So we get a success message. So now we can go back to our report and you see this visual just updated. Now we have a button that says run a flow. You probably don't want this to say run a flow. You want it to be something more descriptive. So what you'll do is you'll click on the visual, click on the format button, find this button text property and change that to whatever you'd like. So I might change this to say send Teams reminder. We can do things like change the fill if we want. So I might change this to more of that Teams purple color. And I'm gonna shrink it down just a bit. Okay, let me give this a save. So let's open it and give it a test. So I would come in here, use the filter to find today's date. Looks like I have two trainings for today. So let's see if this button works. Let's click the send Teams reminder. You can see it updates to triggering, letting me know that it's going and working. We get a successful triggered message there right on the button. Now, if I go into Teams and go into that general channel in my training team, we'll see there is the message from my Flowbot with that tabular data in here from our Power BI report. We have those two trainings, their title, description, and the date and time. So it's really as easy as that to trigger a flow manually right in your Power BI reports and dashboards. I hope you found this video helpful. If you did, do me a favor, click like and subscribe, and I'll catch you in the next video.